Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time for a Tainted Maggie run. Yes, indeed. We're going to be playing as Tainted Maggie today for a Wacky Wednesday. Some people have been requesting to see her, and I figured why not? We'll play some Kung Fu Master Maggie because it's been a little while. And on top of that, very happy to report that we did indeed hit the like streak goal for all Beastie Week, which is going to begin on Sunday, May 1st. Seriously, thank you all very much who made it possible. I know the like streak has been wonky with all the bugs and stuff that's been going on YouTube. We've had ups, we've had downs. It's not really technically a streak anymore, but I do want to say still thank you all very much for the patience and understanding during all that stuff. And hey, it's just a great goal to have something to do, to aim for every single day here, as well as to, of course, promote and grow the channel in the algorithm, as well as with a wider range of audience. So again, thank you all very much for making that possible. I really do appreciate it. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Friend G. Title of the thread was literally every floor. it's a tragedy. What can I say? It is a tragedy whenever lost soul buddy die. I can't even say that with a straight face. Thank you very much to Friend G and all 139 of you who upvoted that. Tainted Maggie, here we go today. C-Day is going to be 033 Romeo Tango 7 Yankee 7. And oh yeah, we did get Eden's Blessing yesterday. So we have Little Chad to start us off here. And Little Chad's actually a huge, huge, huge get for us because of the way that Tainted Maggie's passive works. Essentially, she will always... Oh my god. What is up with these just baller starts that we've been having, man? I don't even know. Wow, Cricket's freaking head. So Tainted Maggie is going to have the lethal hugs. Speaking of hugs and kisses, Chad also gives us some hugs in the form of, well, just dropping out red hearts, half red hearts every now and then whenever we clear room. But with Cricket's head, though, good lord, that is going to be so much damage that we've got. We also get a little spewer, which is going to help us out with a little bit of secondary damage on the creep and whatnot. But yeah, Tainted Maggie, as long as you have more than two red hearts of HP, she will actually bleed and lose that HP and down to those two red hearts like we talked about. This includes going through soul hearts and black soul hearts and that sort of thing. So you got to be careful. Red hearts, red hearts, red hearts are the name of the game. Now you might be wondering, Victor, how does it work with Devil Deals? How do you even qualify if you got to take all this damage to get all these red hearts back? Well, the thing is that with Tainted Maggie's HP, until you're down to those two hearts, you actually have basically a soft soul heart. Those temporary hearts that you see them kind of blinking. Oh man, if we could get Nun's Habit is just GG already. But I don't think we're gonna get enough HP, or we're not gonna get enough money for that. But if you see those blinking hearts, those temporary hearts up there, those are essentially soul hearts. As crazy as it may sound, Maggie can actually maintain her Devil Deal as long as she has those temporary hearts rocking and rolling. They will count as a soul heart. And I'll talk about that more in a moment because, yeah, we're bleeding. So an effective way to save yourself from losing your deal with the devil or deal with the angel in this case, which you should always go for the deal with the angel on Maggie, no matter what. That is an undeniable fact. You should almost always go for angel deals no matter what, because you've got so many more defensive options. You have easy ways to get back the HP if you're protected, and of course if you get something big. Like a Sacred Heart or a Godhead, anything like that, then you're lapping. You're already happy. So we can take Red Heart damage down to two. Now, if you may notice that she also starts off with Yum Heart in her offhand passive slot. This Yum Heart is very special because not only does it gives you the same heal, of course, but Tainted Maggie actually heals for more if you use Yum Heart. So she heals for two hearts instead of one, meaning that if you're down to the two permanent red heart containers, and you actually do happen to, this doesn't matter. Well, I mean, I guess we can use Yum Heart. And you do happen to use it before you take that red heart damage on your permanent soul heart or permanent red heart containers, you will prevent yourself from losing the deal with the devil or deal with the angel. So Yum Heart is very crucial in preserving that, and having the ability to save yourself a deal with the devil essentially is giving you two temporary soul hearts like that is extremely powerful. So if you play Tainted Maggie right, you're going to have a lot of fun. She's very powerful. Her damage like scales like no other. Especially with the amount of damage that we've got right now. I mean, it is we're balling out of control here. We get range and damage up. Range and tears up, I should say, here from Mr. Dolly. I do kind of want to go look into the curse room. We got to hurry, though, because we don't want to lose this bone heart. Bone hearts are going to be very, very good for us. And we get two soul hearts anyway. Maybe? No, it's not there. No. I should have known it's already there. And we don't have enough money to make the store worthwhile, so I'm just going to go ahead and head on down to the next floor. Again, we're going to reject Stanley here, go for the angel deals. Man, we've got ourselves... I mean, our damage is going to be insane. It already is insane. Curse of Loss is a little bit unfortunate, but... As you see here, we don't even have to use the hugs of the lethal hugs anymore. Oh my goodness, and we get Fishtail as well. Fishtail is going to give us another fly every time we produce a fly. I don't think it synergizes with the mulligan though. It might. I don't know. I don't think we're gonna have double fly payouts, but like I said, we might. Mysterious Paper is also not terrible either on Tainted Maggie, but the problem is that it's hardly ever going to trigger because we're always gonna have two hearts, no matter what. Should I also mention I might be pausing a couple of times in this video. I've currently got food in the oven. I'm making my fancy chicken and noodles dish. It's one that Mama Victa taught me a long, long time ago. And I gotta pause once to go put the noodles in the water. The water's currently boiling. Well, it's not boiling yet, but when it does boil, I'll pause the video. In an appropriate location. Again, it's going to be minimal impact to you all here because obviously it's instantaneous. But for me, like, you know, I can take as much time as I want whenever I pause the recording, which is a very useful thing to have. Hey, the Polaroid there. OBS doesn't do a lot of things that I like right, but some of the things it does do right. One of them was definitely pausing recording. That was a nice feature if someone unexpectedly comes to the door, or if I got to answer the phone for an important phone call. Or in this case, cook myself some dinner like a well-adjusted adult that I am. So we don't have to use Yum Heart yet. 3 cent Soul Heart. Soul Hearts are... I don't want to say they're useless. They're not useless, but they're kind of useless. On Tainted Maggie anyway. Excuse me, I got the hiccups. We don't know where our item room is yet, and I don't want to have to come back and search for it, so... Get this out of the way now. Little Spewer, by the way. A little Spewer will shoot out a line of creep. Depending on what pill we use, actually, it's going to change. Or actually, it's not dependent on the pill that we use. It just kind of changes whenever you use a pill. It can be anything from like a circle, like a white circle on the ground, to like poison creep, to blood creep. Apparently just using our navigational skills here to hopefully try to find our item room. I'm not going to use Yum Heart until we absolutely have to. Thank you, little Chad, for finally coming up with something. Yeah, we got a couple bombs here, which is good. Find our item room, and we're going to laugh as we do not want that. Although Guillotine, Tainted Maggie would be one of the few characters where I would say that the Guillotine is not entirely a piece of trash. Wow, we actually got it. I was like, ah, screw it. Might as well try. Piggy Bank's going to give us a chance to give it a coin every time we take damage, and of course with the frequency that we are taking damage on Tainted Maggie, which is going to be a lot because you're obviously going to be running into things. Having something like that is pretty nice. Yeah, we're gonna try to bum rush Gertie here. Yeah, that's just so much damage from Cricket's Head. we don't get a deal with the devil, or do a deal with the angel, I should say, and we're going to head on down. And I am going to pause the recording at the beginning of the next floor, just as a warning. Well, the water's not boiling yet, unfortunately. Gives me time to clear a couple more floors here. But to really get an appreciation of how well, like you just saw with Gertie Jr., how well damage scales with Maggie, like we're going, like Tainted Maggie, we're going to have to use the hugs here, which is, it's dangerous because obviously, like, if we lose our soul heart, like, we can't recover the soul hearts. But at the same time, because we have Piggy Bank, like, we're kind of incentivized to get hit a little bit more. We just don't want to lose the Bone Heart. The Bone Heart is the biggest thing. So we have our, we have full charge now on Yum Heart. Feel comfortable with taking damage here. If we have to. I'd prefer not to have to fight, you know, champions right now. Gotta watch out for them corn flies. Movement speed, obviously, just like Tainted Keeper, is a premium for Maggie because you need to be able to get in there. Get that extra HP while it's still there. Not gonna go in the vault. We only have two keys. Secret room could be to the left of the vault. That would also save us our two keys. That is one thing we do have, is plenty of bombs. Yeah, look at that. We just absolutely smashed Larry Jr. No problem at all. We just kicked his soul in. I do kind of wish that Maggie had a, if she had like a charge kick or something like that, would do like a Mars-esque type charge. One that you could control, of course. I'm not going to take soy milk. Soy milk kills us, basically. Soy milk takes everything that we have good right now and ruins it, because Maggie gains absolutely no benefit from it. We're losing so much damage for literally no reason at all. Tears rate doesn't really matter for Tainted Maggie. What you do want is damage, and we've got damage. One thing we don't have right now, another thing we don't have right now, are Yaves. We got Bombas, we don't have Yaves. Look, game, I appreciate you trying to get me to, like, take all these terrible items, but I don't want it. The fact that we got soy milk and almond milk on the same floor is kind of offensive. Like, speak to your manager, please. Okay, so we now are off of off of soul hearts, so we got to be careful. We got to be careful with respect to our bone heart. I mean, nice little back kick there from Maggie. So we got to be careful with this bone heart here. It's going to be Bighorn. We should get an opportunity to knock him down. Well, the bone heart failed right as we moved to position ourselves next to Bighorn. Pretty poor timing there. We do get our angel deal, and we get a range upgrade. Magla Conception, honestly, I'm totally fine with it. Again, because of how frequently we're going to be taking damage, it should pay out pretty quickly. Sorry about that. So yeah, Cammy Conception is going to give us a lot more, just, it gives us a lot more for what we're already doing, which is just taking damage, obviously, when we have to. I mean, I know that we're shooting currently, and honestly, we're getting a little bit spoiled. Well, we're getting a lot of it spoiled by Cricket's head right now, but I will take more HP if we can actually get some, because honestly, like, our damage right now with the hugs of death, hugs of doom, with Maggie is still going to be quite nice. We're end up getting the meat cleaver here, which is also going to help us out. Yeah, we can go ahead and do this. A little bit of a misplay there. You should never go into the red chest until after it is until it's the only one left in the room, obviously, because if you get teleported out, then you have to open up like another chest, then obviously, like, you've basically ruined it. So the meat cleaver tainted Maggie is interesting because we get to make the enemies a lot more susceptible to getting one shot, but we make more enemies, and because of that, we also get this weird sort of synergy with tainted Maggie where we can get because we're splitting them and creating more enemies. That means that we're basically making more opportunities for us to get our HP back, as you just saw in this room right here, which was very satisfying to watch, by the way. Yeah, so again, we don't really care about soul hearts. The only thing that we really truly care about is just not taking damage on our permanent heart containers. So, and as I was saying at the beginning of the run, obviously, even if we go down to our permanent heart containers and we only have soul hearts left, it will still burn away from us, despite them being soul hearts. So you have to keep that in mind. Getting all the yaves now. Give them yaves. Now you're going to bother using the meat cleaver in here. Meat cleaver is very good against big bosses as well. It sort of halves their HP totals. Very curious to see if Cambion Conception will actually pay out with something good for us. Wow, we're getting even more swords. Oh, we got the relic. The relic coming out of Cambion Conception. Or not Cambion Conception, Immaculate Conception. Oh, baby. Well, the relic is going to give us a soul heart every four rooms or so. It's like three or four rooms, something like that. Super secret room is... No, this is the regular secret room? Nani? Interesting. I would have never suspected... That is the regular secret room. That is not the super secret room. And we're going to get war here. It's going to be Black War. So this is interesting because war will give us an orbital, obviously. We do get our angel deal here, and we get the rosary, too. That's just super-duper awesome. I mean, the rosary is a tears up, but it gives us soul hearts, which we don't need, as I just got done saying. And we're doing okay on HP right now, so I'm not going to use... We don't need to use Yum Heart, and honestly, having the strength card here is going to help out a lot as well. So plenty of time to make boss rush too, which is surprising considering how much we've the navigation has not been terrible. We only had one Curse of Lost and we went straight to where we needed to go. Now Globins are a little bit tricky. As Tainted Maggie, you don't necessarily want to be fighting Globins unless if you just have either the wafer or if you just have a ton of HP, which we do have a good amount of. We don't have unlimited, obviously. Gonna switch over to the strength or off the strength card as well and go to Yum Heart here. I don't want to accidentally use that because the strength card is going to be everything for us. Oh yeah, that's the good stuff right there. That's the good stuff right there, Maggie. Look at that, 77 cents now thanks to the piggy bank. With the Bible and Satanic Bible. Honestly, I like the meat cleaver. I'm sticking with meat cleaver here. I really, really wish that we could have gotten Nun's Habit. So having the orbital here is just going to give us more damage whenever we do go for... A little late for that. Whenever we do go for the... the melee attack here, I'm going to use this on Wrath. Wow. Man, you just watch the HP of our bosses just melt away. We haven't been into the item room yet, so we should be able to spawn one despite it just dropping in the room before, I think, anyway. No, take that back. It's going to be a little Brimmy. Come on, little Brimmy. Come on, little Brimmy. Yeah, but with the golden fishtail, it's hard to pass that up. I think we gotta take the glowing hourglass. As much as I want to stick with the meat cleaver for all the reasons that I just got done talking about, glowing hourglass really does make it easy for us to undo a lot of stuff, a lot of bad damage. Emperor card's even probably better, question mark, than the strength card. So if we lose our angel deal somehow, we're able to basically undo that and use the glowing hourglass to just simply just do, you know, do whatever room that we want to undo over again. I definitely want to get a little bit more HP, though. As in red heart containers. I know that it's weird. It's weird hearing me say that, hey, we want some more red hearts, but we could definitely use some. So most likely we're probably going to have to use Yum Heart in the mom fight. A little tricky, tricksy dodge there. Oh, maybe not. Let's see. You get a luck upgrade, and I will take this other heart here. Now, obviously, we've made it to Boss Rush. But Boss Rush would have to be something pretty incredible for me to even care about. Gonna use Yum Heart here just to protect us. There we go. We do not get an angel deal, unfortunately. Magic Fingers. Magic Fingers is not terrible. Seraphim. Yeah, this is not a boss rush we want. Honestly, I'm feeling pretty good. I'm feeling good. We can go for more damage here. Victory lap with Tainted Maggie is always a little bit up in the air because you do have to worry about fighting Lamb. I'm encouraged by the fact that we have the Glowing Hourglass and the Mulligan. That's going to help out a lot. Our tears rate is, of course, excellent right now because it's maxed. I'm going to start getting on the ball here and getting these red hearts. This is a global D20, which we just got screwed out of a key. Honestly, give me my three keys back. I don't want it. We need to be careful about the HP damage that we take now because obviously we're in the womb. Womb and Hire is going to take away one full red heart from us, not a half heart, unless we get cancer or if we get the wafer, which we obviously have not had yet. But I'm hopeful, really hopeful. But now is when we kind of transition into a regular Isaac run because we do have to be sparing with how often we use our melee, unless we're just getting accosted by like a bunch of like close range enemies that are just charging right at us, so that we can guarantee to get some HP back. We have to be cautious about we just have to be cautious about overdoing our bro. Come on. I thought about undoing it there, but Mama Gertie's gonna be a mama pain in the butt. Let's try to burn her down. Okay, that wasn't too bad. That was a 73% deal with the devil. Failure. Well, 68%, but bombs, diamonds. Yeah. Nope, stick with the Emperor card. Not a fantastic floor for us, though. Booster pack is practically worthless at this point. We have five keys, so we could theoretically reroll the floor with the D20 key still. For two key, I mean, it's going to cost us more than that. It's going to cost us basically all five of our keys. Whipworm. Yeah, it's not worth it. Not worth it. Thank you, Glowing Hourglass. So yeah, kind of a big swing and a whiff there on this floor. Not the greatest. Could be there, and we are going to be going down to a 2.5 heart HP container situation. Which again is kind of the reason why I was like, you have to kind of pause for a moment to think about whether or not it is worth going for the lamb or not. Obviously, if you're doing unlocks, then you have to. But you know, is this a run where we can get a couple unlocks done? It probably would be. I'll leave that red heart there. It's a very big heart for us. I'll switch the yum heart just in case. I do get a key, so I'm not going to undo the damage from the a mimic chest. Go in here. We get a bomb. Yeah, we have the luxury of doing that. We can also take pills if we really, really wanted to. Our movement speed, the lack of movement speed upgrades is definitely the biggest problem right now, other than HP. HP is not exactly, I would say, a problem necessarily, but it could become a problem very quickly. But, I mean, that's any given Isaac run, though. It doesn't matter who you're playing as. It doesn't matter if you're playing as Tainted Maggie. It doesn't matter if you're playing regular Isaac, Kane. It just doesn't matter. You're always going to have those situations. You're always going to have those situations where it's just, you know, your HP and repentance can go very quickly. Okay, well, that is a full clear and a half right there. All right. All righty. Utilize a little Brimmy here as well. We do need the long range attacks. Excuse me. You can't hesitate as well. Whenever you're talking about losing the option to get the HP that the enemies drop as Tainted Maggie, you cannot hesitate in your directional choice. Because you gotta commit. Otherwise, if you hesitate, the hearts are gonna disappear lickety split, and then that's that. Wow, we cannot stop going the wrong way. Glowing hourglass definitely bolsters my confidence a little bit fighting the lamb. Or really any boss, we just have to make sure that we've got it on off cooldown. On off cooldown. Key relic. But timing is everything with Tainted Maggie as well, and that's the reason why getting dead ends is more annoying than it usually is, because we are on a timer. Our HP literally will run down to two, and then, you know, we're basically only one hit from death at that point. Now, range upgrades as well, that's something I haven't talked about, but range upgrades for Tainted Maggie aren't necessarily the worst things in the world, because it does increase the range that you can activate your deadly hug from. The Eternal Heart's huge here. The Eternal Heart is absolutely huge. We do get an angel deal. I mean, I live a balance, like we're. I'm going to go Glyph of Balance here because I think that it works pretty well with Tainted Maggie. I think. I'm going to head on down. But again, that Eternal Heart is big. Any Red Heart containers that we can get as an upgrade here for late game is huge. And the Eternal Heart, that gives us a little bit of wiggle room. Having another Red Heart container is going to bolster our survival by a whole lot. It means that we can plow into enemies even more. And overall, just means that we're going to have a safer and more enjoyable run. Because we can use Tainted Maggie and not have to rely on our tears so much. There we go. Yum Heart, again, is just going to be super important as well. Try not to walk on the creep too much. Magic skin is an actual death trap. Getting broken hearts as Tainted Maggie is not what you want. Get another Emperor card. We already have one. This Emperor card is going to be pretty important. I mean, I guess we could go fight Stanley. This is pretty much a disaster of a room here. We could go fight Stanley now. Yeah, I'm gonna do it now. We'll come back and get the other Emperor card. While we got these two Soul Heart, or well, one Soul Heart. we can't really ball with Stanley though. We gotta do this the hard way. It's a big red heart right there. Good. When we run out of this heart that we're currently on, I will go. Oh, we got holy water too. I just didn't realize that. Use Yum Heart. Okay. Wow, we went a long way away. Good lord, look how far we are away from our Emperor card. This Emperor card that we have from the other floor is going to be ideal. Because then we can go straight to Lamb, but we need to make sure. Here's the caveat in that. We need to make sure that we have enough HP to fight Lamb, and we also have the Glowing Hourglass off cooldown, and we also have Yum Heart off cooldown. That's the three big problems that we have here. It's a great little block there by our Guardian Angel. We did get Guardian Angel and Swarm Protector as well from Immaculate Conception, which is to be expected given the fact that we do take, you know, a ridiculous amount of damage when you're playing as Tainted Maggie. But I mean, that's how the character's played. Like, that's just how it is. I don't think I've ever entered this room from the opposite direction. It's a little bit strange. I'm gonna leave that there. So again, we make our way back all the way, and we were going the wrong direction, of course, for our Emperor card. Now we can double back and go into the cursed room. We can actually bomb our way in there. Make sure I don't accidentally use the Emperor card here. And this is our last hurrah through this level, so we should pick up these hearts. Leave that one. Really hoping there's the mark or something in here that can give us a movement speed upgrade. Or it could just be a Demon Judgment, which is actual not good ideas. Okay, we gotta hurry here. If we get into the Dark Chest now, we can definitely use the Emperor card, just rip it. I'll take a brief glance at what our W options are. No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. Wait, where's our Emperor card? Oh, wait, I'm stupid. Never mind. Don't listen to me. can I undo me saying that? This is hungry Victa talking right now. We do get an Eternal Heart here. I highly, highly doubt that this Eternal Heart's gonna live. We just can't go in there. I knew that he was gonna do that. We got him, almost got the Eternal Heart too. Victory lap on Tainted Maggie is dangerous because everything causes one heart of damage, but we gonna do it anyway. We gonna do it anyway. Kilo Sierra 4 Whiskey Quebec 6 Quebec Zulu. So yeah, we gotta be careful here. Gotta be careful. Cannot overstate that. We have got to be careful on a victory lap because every single hit of damage is going to, oh my goodness, double Yum Heart. That's four hearts that we get to regenerate. I think I'm gonna go ahead and take that. That makes us virtually unkillable, and we get, well, not almost unkillable. We get the Pentagram, which is gonna give us a huge amount of damage. I mean, massive amount of damage up, thanks to Cricket's Head. Wow. Everything coming up Millhouse here. This is a waste of 5 cents, but yeah, we got our heart for it. Yeah, double Yum Heart. I'm good with this. Being able to undo rooms, yeah, that's important stuff. But, I mean, when you can regenerate 4 full hearts of damage, like, that's incredible. As Tainted Maggie, I'll take that all day, every day. Took us longer to walk up here than it did to clear the level with the boss kill. Hey, one bomb for 2 and a penny. Seems like a pretty good trade to me. All right, we're doing it. Eternal Heart, Soul Heart. Let's go. Curse of Lost, there is a bedroom there. This is a situation where it doesn't really matter if they're champions or not, just because of the fact that we, like, have... I mean, it's a victory lap, so we're going to be getting hit no matter what for full hearts of damage. Oh, look at the HP flow here. We're actually at full HP right now. But don't worry, there's no shortage of us going the wrong way. That's just the staple here. Still no movement speed upgrade, which I'm actually a little bit annoyed about now. I mean, one movement speed upgrade makes a big difference. We get another Eternal Heart, yo. That's sick, swag, crazy, y'all. Oh, baby. Get the apple as well, which is going to allow us to fire off a little Azerade every now and then. The major, just a little razor shot that's going to deal an increased amount of damage. It does give us a tiers upgrade, but of course we are capped and have been capped for a while on our tiers, so we're at the soft cap. That is not a... I don't know why I'm doing that. It's not like we need money or anything. Ooh, man, that damage. We get another angel deal here. We get Marrow, which I don't really care. We'll just get another relic, I guess. Yeah. It's absolutely spanked. Down goes Uriel. And I will take Marrow. I'm happy that we have this Eternal Heart. Let us do it. You know what? Let's go all path. Hey, a visit to Alt Path. Doesn't necessarily mean we're going to go fight Mother, but... we'll pay a visit down to the doldrums down here. Adrenaline will help us out a little bit, but... I was kind of hoping that it was going to be one of the better syringe items. Mystery Gift. I mean, we can get ourselves another Angel Deal item. No, our secret room's got to be in between the curse room and the item room. Bostomia, I don't care about the bone heart at this point, because we're going to get more Eternal Hearts thanks to Guardian Angel. We do get Synth Oil, however. But we did not get our... We didn't get our Angel deal, which I'm a little bit sad about. Yeah, I don't know where our secret room is. Not there. It can't be there. Can't be there. Has to be here. It's the only other place. Spear Shackles. I don't think that matters. Now you know we're getting risky. I feel like this run is powerful enough to do it. It's not the most powerful Tainted Maggie run I've ever seen, that's for sure. The lack of movement speed definitely disturbs me a little bit. That's like we still are bleeding despite us being as the Lost. I'm not fighting Colostomia. There's no way you're going to get me to fight Colostomia right now. We could take her probably, but I definitely just don't even want to mess with that boss. You go back and get our Yumheart here. Really, the dual Yumheart is what's kind of driving me to go for Mother here. Oh, we get another Emperor card, dude. That is what I like to see. Now, that is a big-time play. Looking for a super secret room. It's there. And it's another Eternal Heart. Yo, we are moving now. I'm liking this. And we're only one away from Spun, I tell you what. More red hearts is the name of the game here. We are going to take Tech Zero. Tech Zero for when those times come where we have to rely on our tears and not our hugs. We have lots of ways to generate HP. More ways than often than we usually do. Still holding on hope that the boss... Now, the perfect upgrade for us, honestly, would be Speedball. That's the perfect boss drop for us. We do not want Apple Sodom. Apple Sodom would be a horrible idea for Tainted Maggie. We're really running out of keys, too. Soul Lazarus, I mean, it's great and all, but it's this Emperor card that we have, because we're going to fight Mother... This Emperor card is going to be very, very important for Corpse, too. Soul Heart. I mean, we're not even using our attacks right now, our hugs, so the Soul Hearts are persisting. Card reading is also very nice. Ignoring the wall crawlers right now. We're just going straight for Reef Creep. Yeah, down he goes. No problem at all. Man, our damage is kicking. And that is a 77% deal with the devil, deal with the angel, failure. Womp, 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 womp. Ash Pit 2, we can go straight to the boss. I think we should, because we have all of our we have most of our HP containers filled. We can always undo. We can come back to get the other key piece here. I think we can. Man, Star of Bethlehem or the Relic. Star of Bethlehem is pretty insane. I will take Star of Bethlehem here. I think. Don't worry, I'm not going in there. I'm just spending our hearts while we have them. I think that it does help out Maggie's hugs. I want to say that's true. And now we have the long, painful process of trying to find our item room. On top of that, we got to go get the second key piece as well. Or knife piece, I should say. No reason for us to use the Yum Heart right now. As you see, we have many, many, many ways of regenerating those hearts that we do lose. I'm even trying to, like, run into things, and they're just dying to the mulligan flies. I mean, our base damage is 8.98, so it's really, really good. Gotta take down the Core Hound. The Core Hound mobs here. Probably should have and could have left that Soul Heart, but oh well. Go check out the ye olde tienda. Got the quarter, which very useful for us. Money equals power would be an amazing drop for us right now as well. And yeah, we're just looking for the item room here. Nothing too big. There we go. On this, we finally. Oh man! Now wafer guarantees that this is a dub here, because getting the half damage, the half heart damage reduction here is just we're overpowered as all heck. Overpowered as all get out here now, especially with these two Yum Hearts. Man, oh man. We're sitting pretty. Very, very strange to see this room without having any mobs in it at all. Okay, but we gotta hurry though, because as you see here, we do not have the use of our Yum Hearts and we're still bleeding. So just wasted a lot of time there. This is imperative that we hurry, because remember, we'll go down to two hearts, and the wafer does save us from instant death if we do get tapped by Mom Shadow here. But we need to just be expedient about this. Gotta go. I cannot stress how big of a deal it is that we got Wafer. I think we're allowed to do that. Yeah. That's your bottom dollar we are. Okay, we made it out. There's a lot of hearts on the ground, and we can use both of our Yum Hearts to recover on the next floor. What we don't want is our HP ticking down and taking out the Soul Heart. So I'm going to double back to this shop here. Grab this heart. Okay. Now we shouldn't need to use both of our Yum Hearts to recover this. Okay. Dehana XL is pretty bad. Because that takes away an angel deal and a shop away from us. Decided to use both of our yum hearts here to give our to give the rest of our red hearts a turns half hearts into full hearts. Pumps locket. Yeah, Mom's Locket means that we get full hearts from our melee drops now and not just half hearts. That is, I mean, how much more do you want? Good Lord. Honestly, I say that we take the easy kill here on Visage anyway. Get blood clot. Hooray. I mean, that is insane. The amount of HP that we can recover now in any given room, I think that really does make us actually unkillable. When you think about it, I mean, Mom doesn't have... Well, she does have killable adds. She does have her shots that she fires. Not Mom, Mother. I really don't think it's going to matter, however. Whatever. Yeah, we can go in the grocery room. We got HP like that. We got the wafer like that. Hey, little chest, I appreciate you being here, but, like, you were just kind of like a extra pickup. You're not really part of the team here, so if you could just stop dropping trinkets that are trying to override my good trinket, I'd appreciate it. This Eternal Heart has a 0% chance of living through this entire level, but we'll hold on to it anyway. We're just looking for the item room. Soul Heart. Got two Soul Hearts here. Maybe the Eternal Heart lives, but we're probably going to have to do a full clear anyway. Star's Car. I will take that for now. We finally get a Mini Mush movement speed upgrade. I don't care, man. Yeah, we were going the way wrong way for this item room as well. Boneheart, we really don't care. Golden Fishtail, I know, but like, just think of all the HP that we're gonna be able to get. Just thought I'd check for the store. I can't believe that the Eternal Heart's gonna live here. Even Monkey Paw would not be a horrible idea, but I don't really care about the store at this point. No. Polaroid. Alright, this is getting ridiculous, game. So you hear us actually recovering HP every time we're using a key. And because of that, we're actually healing for, I think, two hearts. I'll take Immaculate Conception again. And, yeah, we can check Boss Rush. Servant's Kiss. We've got plenty of HP. We really don't need any more. Any more ways to recover HP, I mean. Get another Eternal Heart here thanks to our orbitals. Man, oh man. We're almost at a full spread. A full rack of HP as Tainted Maggie. That is scary. Unfortunately, we did not get a red portal. Now we can really start being liberal with our use of the lethal hugs here, because I mean we've got so much HP that we're gonna recover it almost instantaneously on anything that we attack. I don't think it's possible for the game to deal enough damage to kill us before we recover it. And remember, we have the wafer and double Yum Heart. I mean, just like just look at what happened right there. We are laughing at the game right now. We have become the unkillable. Booster pack again, and that's another 73% deal with the angel failure. Not that it matters anymore, of course. Gonna take our Emperor card, and we are gonna wrap this one up because, man, oh man, what a run. What an absolute monster run. We didn't even need the Emperor card. Oh boy. Well, if you ever wanted to see Maggie just kick the ever-living crap out of Mother, just watch and learn, boys and girls. I mean, we're literally going to kick the ever-living crap out of her. I mean, even Old Bandage, like, I didn't even talk about Old Bandage's, you know, possibility of just giving us infinite HP. Old Bandage has a chance to pay out with a red heart every time we take damage, and every time it does, we just undo all the damage that we've done to ourselves. And we still have all four of our Yum Hearts ready to go. Down she goes. Didn't even have to use the Yum Hearts. Unbelievable. What a run. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. How could you not have? Tainted Maggie absolutely slaughtering the entire game. What a build. What a run. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you had a great start to your Wednesday here in the Mosh Pit. Don't forget that my weekly streams begin on Wednesday through Saturday, starting at 5 p.m. Central, 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Unless if I tweet otherwise, sometimes I take an extra hour to get things done. But either way, I do appreciate you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Katoriu, El Mazarito, Jeremy Mojaves, Fred, and Monty Dickey. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/sinvicta.